In algae, we have studied they are aquatic in nature. They are aquatic in nature, but in case of bryophytes, they are terrestrial in nature. They are found in moist and shady places. They are found moist and shady places. Their body, in comparison to algae, is little more complicated. They are found on moist and shady places and terrestrial, but a few species are aquatic, but most of these species are terrestrial. They are terrestrial, but for fertilization, water is essential. Without fertilization, bryophytes cannot fertilize. That is why bryophytes are called as amphibia plant kingdom. These are called as amphibia plant kingdom. They are terrestrial nature, but for sexual reproduction, they require water. Without water, reproduction is not possible. Since to complete their life cycle, water is necessary. So they are called as amphibia plant kingdom. Body phallus its body is phallus. As before I told you, there is no differentiation in root stems and leaves. It is not differentiated into root, stem and leaf. As you know that in case of the you observe the plant of the banana tree, banana plant or the mango tree. You see they have root, stem and leaves, but these plants having no root, stem and leaf. But they have root, stem and leaf like structure. They have a root, stem and leaf like structure, but actually they do not have root, stem and leaf. That is why I have write the term as leaf like structures. Actually, these are not root, stem and leaves, but root, stem and leaf-like structures. So these are the phallus. Maybe erect sometimes tell us,
even here,
prostrate or erect. Maybe prostrate or erect.
The diagram it is given in our book.
So you see diagrams of the bryophyte. This is diagram bryophyte. This is, these are the diagrams of the bryophytes. So thallus means prostate or erect. Or erect. If you see the thallus, or thallus may be such big. Sometimes when dicot muscle is branched, is thallus. This is prostate thallus. Thallus, this is, and they are breast. This is thallus, is here. They are attached with the ventral site, and sometimes thallus may be leafy. Actually, it is not a leaf, but leafy bryophytes, and these are the rhizoids and some apexes. So the structure is there. These are the, this axis, this is leaf, and this is the sporophyte. Such structures is there when we discuss about the bryopsida or the masses, then we will describe these things. So this is thallus is there, this is thallus is prostate, and this thallus is erect. Thallus may be prostate or erect. Thallus is green in color and autotrophic in nature. These are autotrophic in nature, green in color. So these are autotrophic in nature. Thallus is attached to the substratum with the help of rhizoids. Rhizoids. Rhizoids function just like the root of the higher plants. They function just like the root of the higher plant. You know the function of the root? Roots are meant for absorption and fixation. They fix the thallus to the substratum and absorb water and minerals for the thallus. So this is rhizoids. The rhizoids may be unicellular or multicellular. Unicellular or unicellular, half multicellular. Smooth or tuberculated. These unicellular and multicellular, some members have the unicellular rhizoid and some members have the multicellular rhizoids. Rhizoids may be smooth or tuberculated. Smooth rhizoid, this is just like rhizoid is there. And this is smooth rhizoid. And next one, that is the tuberculated rhizoid. This is the smooth rhizoid and this is tuberculated rhizoids. So two types of rhizoids are there. One is smooth and other is tuberculated. So this is smooth rhizoid, this is tuberculated rhizoid. So two type rhizoids are there. Unicellular or multicellular, smooth or tuberculated, and branched or unbranched. Branched or branched and unbranched. So these are the rhizoids. So function of rhizoids is to observation and fixation to the plant. The function of rhizoid is to absorb water and mineral for the plant and it fix plant to the substrate. One more, this structure is found on the lower surface, lower sides or ventral sides. Suppose this is the thallus, this thallus suppose, and this is dorsal side, this is ventral side. So from this side, this side is in the again the sun and this is side toward the earth. So this side rhizoid is coming here and these rhizoids help in the observation and fixation to the thallus. And one more structure is found on the front, not all the members, but some members having the scales. Some members have the scales on ventral side of thallus. So these are the scales. Help in the conservation of the moisture. The function of scale is to conserve the moisture. So on the ventral surface of the thallus, there are two types of structures. One is rhizoid and other is scales. Rhizoids and scales, two structures may be present in the to the lower surface of the to the ventral surface of the thallus. Scales is not found in all the members, but a few members have these scales. But rhizoids is found in all the members. Your rhizoids function is the observation and fixation, while the function of scale is to conserve the moisture. So main plant body is gametophyte. Main plant body is gametophyte. One term we listen here, the gametophyte. The body which produces the gamete is called as a gametophyte, and it is haploid in nature. Gametophyte is always haploid in nature, while sporophyte is diploid in nature. Very easily you can understand about the gametophyte and the sporophyte in the plant which you observe the nature. Very commonly you image the plant as the mango tree. As in case of the mango tree, this mango tree having also the gametophyte and the sporophyte, but the dominant plant in case of the mango is sporophyte. The plants you observe, the root, stem, leaves, these are the sporophyte, these are the diploid. And during flowering time, flowers come, and this flower is gametophyte. This flower is gametophyte, because flower produces male and the female reproductive part, and these male and the female reproductive part producing male and the female gamete. You know the male reproductive part of the flower and female reproductive part of the flower very, very well. I'm not going behind that one is the. So these flowers are the gametophyte. So flower producing gamete, so it is called gametophyte. But rest part of the mango tree is sporophyte, means diploid. So understand it. So in this way, this is gametophyte. So main plant body is gametophyte. So gametophyte is autotrophic. Gametophyte is autotrophic nature. It is green in color. Sporophyte depends on gametophyte. Sporophyte depends on gametophyte. So this is sporophyte depends on the gametophyte. Let us discuss about the, what is the main about the sporophyte. So plant that is gametophyte. So where gametes are produced in the gametophyte. Here plant having male and female reproductive parts. Male reproductive parts are called male reproductive part is called Anthridia. Anthridia, which produces male gamete called anthrozoites. And while from this line at when deployed, female reproductive part is called Archegonia. Which produces female gamete called So anthrozoites are plant nature. This is also a plant nature. So male reproductive part having, as you know that the flowers are reproductive part. We have also reproductive part, male and female reproductive part. In the same way, bryophytes have also male and the female reproductive part. As male reproductive part in flower part, we are asking N3D androecium. The same way, here male reproductive part is called Anthridia. Anthridia. Anthridia is the plural part. So this is Anthridia, and Anthridium is singular part. So in Anthridium, male gametes are produced. As male gametes in human beings, sperms, the same way in this case, male gametes are known as anthrozoites. Anthrozoites are biflagellates because they have to swim. They have to swim in the water to bring about the process of the fertilization. So here anthrozoites are biflagellates, and you know these are the haploid in nature. These are haploid in nature. In the same way, male reproductive, female reproductive part of bryophytes is known as the archegonia. It is called as the archegonia. This archegonia is the female reproductive part. Archegonia is the plural form. Archegonium is singular form. So this archegonia is female reproductive part. As in case of the flower, which is female reproductive part, gynecium or the carpel, you can say. So as endosium is male reproductive part and female reproductive part is gynecium, in the same way, in this case, this is the female reproductive part of the archegonia, and these archegonia having female gamete called as the egg. Each one archegonium contains single egg, but one anthridia produces a large number of the sperms. So this is Anthridia and the Archegonia. Anthridium producing only. Anthridium producing a large number of anthridioids, while Archegonia producing only a single Archegonia, single egg. And these thallus are two types. Some thallus contains both male and the female reproductive part. When same thallus, when a thallus contains both male and the female sex organs, such thallus is called as the monoecious. And if the thallus contains either male reproductive part or female reproductive part, such thallus is known as the, or such situation is called the dioecious condition. So two conditions are there, two terms are there, monoecious condition and dioecious condition. In the monoecious condition, both male and the female reproductive parts are found on the same thallus. While in dioecious condition, only one reproductive part will be on one thallus. One thallus will contain either male reproductive part or female reproductive part. So, understanding you. So, in this way, these are about the male and the female reproductive part. After fertilization, for fertilization, water is necessary. Without water, fertilization is not possible. So, water is necessary for fertilization. Male and female gametes come in contact with each other, so that bring about the process of the fertilization. And just after fertilization, division not takes place. Embryo forms, and that ultimately gives rise to another structure that is called sporophyte. And in the sporophyte, meiosis, spore mother cell is there, and which undergoes into meiosis cell division and bring and producing spores and producing spores. And these spores, after germinating, gives rise to new plants. So time is less, so we have to next time we will discuss more about this bryophyte from the about the reproduction by bryophyte. So if any question, you may unmute and you may ask any question if you have any query. Now you may ask any question, anybody? Who asked those? Ask those. Now you can unmute. So, have you any query?
No, sir.
No, who is?
No, sir. No, sir.
Rashri, Pratik, Astos. Okay, so thank you. That's for today.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.